Okay, as we know about conduction band and valence band, so let's say these are conduction band and valence band. We are discussing with semiconductors. So we know in valence band, electrons are there. Okay, in valence band, electrons are there. So when the temperature increases, these valence electrons will have sufficient energy to overcome the forbidden energy gap, okay, and then they will move to the conduction band. So in this process, when electron moves from valence band to conduction band, so this electron has moved from here to here, so there will be some unfilled region which will be now present in the valence band. That unfilled region is known as hole. Okay, so these holes act as positively charged carrier, because a hole has the property of attracting an electron. Okay, next is in insulator. In insulator, the energy difference or energy gap between conduction and valence band is very large, around 3 to 4 electron volt. It's greater than 3 electron volt. So in such substance, an electron in the valence band cannot go to the conduction band, because the electron which is present in valence band, it cannot go to the conduction band, because the energy, it requires very large amount of energy to do that. So that's why insulators are bad conductor of electricity, because if this electron was able to reach the conduction band, then it will start conducting electricity. Okay. Next is semiconductors. So semiconductors are partly conducting. Their energy gap is very less, around 1 electron volt for germanium. Germanium is tetravalent element, means it has 4 electrons in the outermost orbit of the atom. And when two germanium atoms will come close together, they will share a pair of electrons between them. Okay. So I'm going to draw the diagram. Let's say germanium has 4 electrons on the outermost shell. So when these two germanium atoms will come close to each other, they will share the electrons, or you can say they will form some covalent bond like this. Okay. Similarly, if there is another germanium atom present here, this germanium atom will form a covalent band with this one. Here, if a germanium atom is present, it will form another covalent bond. So each germanium atom will be surrounded by 4 neighboring germanium atoms. Okay. Now at low temperature, these bonds are very strong. Okay. It is because the shared pair of electrons are shuttled back and forth between the two atoms, holding them close together. But when the temperature of semiconductor increases, these electrons acquire more energy, more thermal energy, because when temperature is increasing, we are basically providing thermal energy to the electrons. So these electrons will absorb the thermal energy and they will start vibrating more. So in that process, the covalent bonds will be broken and the electron will become free, and then they will make themselves available for conduction. Okay. Example, let's say because of the thermal energy, this electron got free. So this electron will come outside and it will become free for the conduction. Now here there will be a deficiency of electron, which is known as hole. So means when one electron is produced, one hole will be generated. Now overall, if you see that this atom will remain electrically neutral, because number of positive charge and number of negative charge will be equal. Okay.